tip who we think are going to be big in the future. Now, the next artist I'm about to play features on a record by the group Chaser Status. The record's called Blind Faith. His name is Liam Bailey. He's from Nottingham. He's mad soulful, and I've tipped him to be massive in 2011. He joins me in the studio. We'll be having a chat with him after this. So this record, so strong out there. Featured artist on it, Liam Bailey, was actually at a rave New Year's Eve, and they dropped it time and time again. Chasing Status featuring Liam Bailey joins me in the studio.
The R&B show with Ronnie Harrell.
Liam, welcome to you, man.
Yes,
mate. How you doing, brother?
Good.
Wicked. Finally get to meet up with you.
Yeah, I'm surprisingly fresh, considering it's been heavy.
Seriously?
Yeah.
Have you been staying in London?
Not in London.
Okay.
Yeah. I was doing New Year's Eve in London. Mm-hmm. Had to cook a big jerk feast for all my bedrooms.
Go on, son.
Yeah.
Yeah, man. Yeah. I could have done with some of that, please. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
But listen, welcome along. I have tipped you to be hot for 2011. Now, let me explain to the One Extra family why I've done that, and just a little bit more about you. Like, because some people, after hearing that, might think, oh, it's just straight up drum and bass and that's it. But it's not about that, is it, really?
No.
For you. Now, you first came to my attention when I was interviewing one of my favourite producers.
Blah!
Salaam Raimi.
Yes.
First of all, we've got to pay homage and salute Salaam Raimi. If you don't know who he is, get to know, man. Look him up. He has been responsible for doing some of the biggest records out there for R&B stars, hip-hop stars, the Fugees, Nas, Amy Winehouse, Tears Dry on their own, like, you know what I mean?
In a Kimosi.
Itty Kimosi, here comes the hot step up. You know what I mean?
Yes.
That is his first real sort of massive hit that he had. And also working with Jasmine Sullivan. Now, I went to interview him and do a very special show on him for the One Extra R&B show. And at the end of the interview, I said to him, so who are you feeling? Who do you think is going to be big sort of in the future? And he went, listen, I'm working with this kid. He's from Nottingham. Let me open my MacBook and play a little tune of his. I was like, all right, cool. Man, cranked it up in the studio. And I can't, to be honest with you, I don't remember what the record was called. It was just, obviously, it was a record that was in demo stage. But, bruv. That's all I'm saying.
It would have been It's Not The Same, no doubt.
It would have been that, right?
Yeah,
okay.
Yeah.
So basically, that was it. That pricked up my ears straight away. And I thought, wow. And I've been on his case. I've been on your label's case as well, just to let me know what's been going on. And I've been playing me some bits.
Mm-hmm.
Incredible, sir. So first of all, I just want to say congratulations for what's coming up in the future. Signed to Lioness Records.
Yeah, well, I'm Polydor. Amy put out two EPs on Lioness.
Amy Winehouse.
Yes.
That's her label.
Yeah, which I was very, very happy about. And that, yeah, so that was the later part of last year.
Okay, how did you hook up with Amy then?
She got to know. And obviously she's not only colleagues with Salaam.
Right.
She's personal friends with him.
Right.
You know, so she got to find out and heard some tracks and called me up. Went round for dinner. Mm-hmm. It was nice, man.
Okay. That's nice. What's it like sitting there having a little chill with Amy Winehouse?
Interesting. She's blessed though. She's blessed.
She's amazing, isn't she?
And it was, I'm one of them people that like to watch people and not, you know, make judgments too quickly.
Of course.
And so I did that with her, and she's a beautiful girl, man. She's really nice.
Props to Amy. Okay, so what is your flavour? I mean, from what I've heard so far, like I said, Salaam, he played the tune for me and, you know, I was sold. It was raw, it's sweet soul, very acoustic. I mean, it was you and a guitar, basically.
Mm-hmm.
So what would you say is your full, you know, your fresh flavour?
Me, I'm like a fat kid at a picnic. I like everything.
Okay.
You know what I mean?
Yeah.
So I can't really say, I mean, my inclination would be a soulful approach. Or bluesy, but it depends, man. I'm a big music lover, so
right.
You know,
you've been compared to the likes of Bob Marley.
No, that's ridiculous.
No, you've been compared. I'm not saying you do sound like him because I don't like to do those comparisons. I've just, you know, I've just been, obviously, like I said, it's for my job.
Yeah.
It's imperative that I find out everything that I need to know about
you. Well, the way I see it is, people are going to be, hopefully people will be surprised about how the album is going to, you know, how they find it, because it's not just one thing on there. There's a few different things and there's a few different tones to my voice at times.
Okay.
It's maybe depending on how late I've been up that night or, you know, how much rest, whatever.
The 2 a.m. rough tracks, which is your first EP that came out sort of earlier on.
They should have called that 2 p.m. rough tracks.
Really? Just up through the night. And that was actually what Your Heart's Not Safe came from, the record that I first heard from you as well. You did a version of I'd Rather Go Blind, Etta James, which is one of my...
Yeah.
That tune is crazy hot, man.
Deep.
I love that version as well. Again, raw, acoustic. What can we expect from the album? Because if you're, it's like you and a guitar on those EP.
Mm-hmm.
Are you going for the full instrumentation?
There's been times where the kitchen sink's been thrown in, but then there's times when we've just left it how it needs to be. It's just going to be all across the board. There's like a track on there called Summer Rain, which is just acoustic with strings behind it, and so you get that flavour. Then there's just straight out and out, almost Beatlesque epicness on there.
Seriously.
Then there's blues and there's soul in it, but it's all me.
Okay.
And it's all thanks to my upbringing and the people around me that put me onto different things, and, you know, my mum's record collection.
What was in your mum's record collection?
Big. Big.
Serious?
Yeah, man. It went from some next level 70s pop like Bread to
Bread, you know.
Bob Marley to Jimi Hendrix to the Beatles to Bee Gees to Dillinger to... Oh, boy.
I can hear it. I can hear it. It's all there.
Yeah, all
it's
there.
Concoction
Funkadelic.
Parliament. Yeah. All right, well, listen, I think we shouldn't let the UK wait any longer.
All right.
We should play a cut from your second EP, which came out at the end of 2010.
Mm-hmm.
So Down Cold is the name of the EP. The track on there called So Down Cold is sick.
Yeah.
Because I'm loving it. Breaking Out as well is hot. But we're going to play Fool Boy.
Mm.
Yeah? And then you can explain what it's about afterwards. Yeah?
All right.
All right, cool. Liam Bailey, my hot tip for 2011, joining me in the One Extra Studios. Let's go with this. Fool Boy.